with respect to transparency and confidence in government, go to page one of the Open Meetings Act. You'll see on some bullet points there, and I'm going to just, first of all, in that first paragraph, toward the middle of the paragraph, you'll say, you need to be careful of dinners, conference calls, brief discussions in the hallway, etc., when you're discussing county business. You as a government agency are going to be discussing county business. That's your charge, that's your task, that's what the Planning Commission was assembled to do. Obviously, we're discussing county business here, right? You're assembled in a duly called work session. You have every right to be discussing county business here. But be mindful of those situations where a quorum of you, which means three, are discussing county business in an environment that's not here or that's not upstairs, that's not been duly called, et cetera, et cetera. Be mindful, be careful about that. And again, a meeting is not so easy. Of course, this is one of the issues I'm discussing right now. It's just through happenstance, having to meet in the hallway. But if you're discussing county business, the operations of the government, that's a meeting, if there's a quorum of it. But there's other more subtle ways to violate the act that aren't just quite that obvious. Be careful, for instance, about announcing a vote or announcing your decision beforehand. And there's an example in this packet. For instance, a chairman of a board opens discussion on a certain issue and indicates that he has the votes necessary to carry the motion. The problem with that is the problem that each of you are thinking of right now, is that if an individual on board forecasts the fact that I've got the votes necessary to make this happen tonight and there's been no discussion, then your reasonable citizen out in the audience is thinking, what? There's been a discussion about this that I've not seen where this decision has been made. And I will tell you that at the Attorney General breakfast down in Savannah, one of the things he mentioned is that I am mindful that in some jurisdictions in this state, there is a lot of decision making that goes on behind the scenes, and these agendas go real quick because all the decisions have already been made, and I don't like that. If the Attorney General doesn't like it, we need to be mindful of it. Okay, so we need to make sure that the citizens understand that our deliberative process is occurring in front of them and not somewhere else. Right? So that's just sort of a subtle thing.
King, can I ask you, because things in the business world are going and do go a lot of times toward a conference call type of thing, if you had, say, you're one or two of us out away from the meeting, is it allowed to actually have the other two call in to a conference call? I mean, it's still open, it's still being recorded.
There's a technical answer to that, and then there's a pragmatic or practical answer to that. The technical answer is, under the Open Meetings Act, phone call quorums are only allowed for certain specifically designated bodies, of which you're not one of those. So that's the technical answer. There are some public agencies that have basically, I think, like statewide membership, and so the law allows them to phone it in. The position I take on that is so long as a quorum is physically present. In other words, let's say that the three of you were here and two wanted to call in, I would allow that so long as there is a quorum physically present. But I'm not going to let a phone call in make the quorum. Is that do you understand? And here's the reason why, and I think the reason the Act takes a dim view of phone-in conversations is I think the Open Meetings Act really wants elected bodies, appointed bodies, to have to sit in front of the constituents and stare into the white of their eyes and them to see the sweat on your brow. You know what I'm saying? I mean, there's a dynamic that is lost if you're not in the room with the people that you're making the decision in front of. And you don't get that on a phone call. On a phone call, you're detached, and maybe you can make a decision, I hate to say this, even easier than if you were there in the room and having to raise your hand and vote on increasing the millage or having to vote on that industrial zone.
I was more talking about this type of meeting, where we're not making decisions where, in front of the public, a public hearing.
Again, so long as you're not making a quorum with your phone in, I typically allow it to occur. Right.
So you'll allow it to occur, but do you frown on it?
I want it to be the exception. Yeah. I want it to be the exception. I don't want that to be a rule. If you've got a commissioner or a planning commission member, a ZBA member, ethics board member that can't make the meetings enough that they're having to phone it in, my respectful recommendation was that person might want to rethink their civic duty. And you know, not that they're not being a good citizen, I'm just saying they may not have the time necessary to do this job. I think to get the most out of it, and quite frankly, to comply the best with the spirit of the rule, you need to be here. But there have been some exceptions where people have really had hardships, and I've allowed them to do that. But I do want to pour them in the room.